Hey, welcome to part two. In the first part, we've looked at this portal, the opening animation, the geometry, the shader, and in this part, we're going to be talking about the particles. More specifically, we are going to be talking about the particles that are being spawned on our portal and the way that the velocity is transferred so that they get pushed outwards when the portal is spinning. In the third part, we are going to be talking about the particles colliding with the ground plane with our custom-made collision tool. So if we look here, this is our whole particle branch, so it's really not that much. And let's look at this without our custom tools. Let's disable them. And it's really just an P image emitter right here, spawning from this completely white background. And let's activate our custom position. And now they're being spawned on our portal. Before I'm going to be talking about this, everything right here, I'm going to use a simpler example just to showcase what we're actually doing. I have prepared this right here. And as you can see, all I've done is I've taken an image emitter using the same white background, and I'm transferring these colors to our particles. And this is literally all we're going to do in the later example as well, only that I can more easily explain it right here. We take a normal image emitter. It only creates particles on the first frame. And with the pcustom tool, we are adding these colors. And this pcustom tool has different tabs. The tab that we are going to be focusing on is the particle tab. And in this tab, this means the rules that we write down here are going to be calculated on each frame, for each channel, for each particle. So each particle is basically a for each loop. And what we have right here is our rule. Okay, so I've reset all the channels and now our particles are back to white. And this is because our image emitter input is completely white. In our pcustom tool, we could change red, for example, to 0. And now they're going to be this blue color because now our green and blue channels are 1 and our red channel is set to 0. And if I set this back to red, it simply uses the color information it got from here. Now let's explain how we get this color to our particles. We're going to use a rule, which is get R1B. The get R simply stands for get the red channel, and the 1B stands for the first image input. And now we're going to use PX, which stands for the particle's position in X, I1, which stands for the normalized position of the 2D image of our first image input remapped to our 3D particles. And we do the same for Y, P, Y, I, 1. And now you might notice that this is a little bit brighter. And if we're going to copy this to our other channels and change red to green and here red to blue, then you can see we are transferring colors, but this is only happening in the positive direction. So we are currently centered, but this is happening only in plus X and plus Y. This is because the 2D coordinate system in Fusion starts at 0 and ends at 1. So we can fix that by adding 0.5 to all our channels. This is right here, and again, change that to green and red to blue. And now we've taken our first image input and mapped the colors to our particles. And this is all we have to do. We are just going to map colors, which are going to stand for positions, to the position of our particles. Okay, and now let's take what we've learned and apply that to our portal. In our pcustom tool, the very same expression we've used below, but we've added that to our position x, y, and z. So first things first, we need to make sure that this is only happening on our very first frame. So we take the h slider to 0 on both start and end. This will make sure that this is only being transferred on the first frame of each particle instead of always, because if we increase this, our particles will always be spawning on our mesh, which we don't want. And okay, but how do we get that position? And that's actually quite easy, because we have our 3D mesh right here, and we are going to replace the material with the information of where this particle is right now in world space. We use this by taking a channel boolean set to x, y, and z position in red, green, and blue, and changing the coordinate space to world. Let's take a look at what this does. So right here I have this shape 3D, which is just a plane, and I've also piped in a channel boolean, again x, y, and z position in red, green, and blue, and changed the coordinate space to world. Now if I'm going to render this with a UV renderer, more about this later, I see that we have these colors, and these colors are going to represent where our mesh is in 3D space. For example, if I take our plane and I move it in Z by 2, we can see down below that now in our blue channel, we have a value of 2. And if I set this to 1, we have a value of 1 in our blue channel. And the same with our X. If I would be right here in the middle, X and Y would be 0, so red and green would be 0, and so on. And this works by rendering out the UV map of our mesh by using the Renderer 3D OpenGL UV renderer. UVs, for those who don't know, are 2D representations of a 3D mesh, which are used for texturing. And this also means that if you are going to import a custom mesh, you will need UVs for this to work. You don't need clean or very good UVs, but you definitely need UVs. Small trivia fact. This is also why in my P-Custom examples, the runner is actually only having a single foot. This is because the feet on that model have stacked UVs, meaning the both feet are using the same UVs. And that's why the particles are being spawned only on one foot and not on both. But if you're going to create a portal like I am right here using the default shape 3D, all have UVs. You only need to be a little bit careful. The cube isn't set on cube mapping by default, because again, this is also now using stacked UV islands. If you set this to cube mapping, you get proper UVs. And the ICO is a little bit weird, because this is also using stacked islands, but not everywhere, so if you should avoid that. But plane, cone, sphere, torus, everything has proper UVs that you can use. So just like I explained before, I'm taking our model, I'm replacing the material with the representation of it in 3D world space, and I'm rendering this using the OpenGL UV renderer. And all the colors that you are seeing right here are representing where our model is right now. It's important that the resolution again is a square, because UVs are usually 1:1 aspect ratio. And it's important that this size is very small, because this is in direct relation to how many particles are being spawned. And 16:16 is already quite enough. And also it's important that this has the very same resolution as the image that you are putting in. This is why I've used several expressions to make sure that the size is always the same. And I've also added this multiplication with the comp proxy scale. This is this right here. So if I were to activate this, the resolution itself would stay the same, but the internal calculations of Fusion would be divided. And this would simply mean that the P image emitter would spawn less particles, and that's not really good for testing purposes. So usually you want to decrease the resolution, but you still want the same amount of particles. That's why I multiply this with the comproxy scale, so I always have 16 by 16 grid of particles being spawned. Okay, so we are rendering out the position of our portal, and we are piping this into our first image input. Okay, back to our pcustom tool. And this is really just the very same rule that we've used below to transfer colors, but this time we are transferring the colors, which stand for position, to the position channels of our pcustom tool, and overwriting the position of our particles that are being spawned from our pimage emitter. The only thing that I've added is this random function, which will create a random value. And I've used the n2, which stands for number input 2, to create the minimum and the maximum value. And I've used the seed random function, which will create a different value depending on the seed. Really use just an arbitrary way of creating a random seed, this time using the position divided by the time. You usually want this to be different on every frame, so you really get random values for each frame. And if I were to disable this, you would see these particles are being spawned very evenly on our portal. But if I increase that number, now these are being spawned more randomly, and this is pretty much what we want. Okay, now that we have brought the position of our particles to the portal, now let's bring the velocity to our particles in the next part.